Hello and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be showing you how to create a villager-powered starter farm for Minecraft 1.16. But before this video starts, I just have a massive favor to ask. About 99% of people watching this right now are not actually subscribed, so if you enjoy my content, please hit that subscribe button. Now let's get right into the video. So as you can see, this farm is not complicated at all. I tried to make it as simple as possible because it is a starter farm. This farm is extremely survival friendly and it doesn't require many materials at all. The only thing that might take you a little while is getting iron for the hopper minecarts and the little hoppers at the bottom, but otherwise, that is it. I'd also like to say this entire farm is automatic, meaning you just have to build it up and pre-plant all of the crops, and the villagers will do all of the work for you. And down here, all of your food will be collected in these chests down below. As you can see, all the potatoes and carrots are in these chests. And in both of these quadrants, your villagers will be farmers, hence the little composter in the middle. And all they'll do is harvest the crops and replant them. And then once their inventory is full of the crops, they will send it over to this villager here. And it will be collected by the hopper minecarts and then be eventually put into these chests at the bottom where you can collect them. Now let's get right into the tutorial. And a quick little disclaimer, I don't know if this farm works on Bedrock Edition, so if you're on Bedrock Edition, just keep this in mind. I don't know if it'll work. I haven't tested it because I don't really know the mechanics in Bedrock Edition for villagers. Alright, to start off with this build, I'd recommend having a flat piece of land so you don't have to do a lot of digging to place this down. To start this farm off, make sure you capture 3 villagers. So let's just say I have a villager here, just place down a boat next to it and the villager will go onto the boat. And just do that with 3 villagers and have them nearby where you're building your little farm. Alright, now you have your 3 villagers, all you have to do now is just place down a water bucket here, just find any place, and this is going to be one of the sectors. Now go ahead and get your netherite hoe, and then just hoe 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces of land like so, and then do that on the other side, another 4, and then do it this way as well, so another 4, just like this. So make a little cross, and then just hoe the land in between the cross. So just make like a little square land, piece of land, just like this. Alright, now you should have a little piece of land like this, and it should be getting hydrated because of the water in the middle. Alright, now go ahead and place down a temporary block here, and then just place down a composter like so, and that should be above the water. And then you just make that back into farmland, and then just place down a block here. Since it's a starter farm, I'm just using torches for light. You can use glowstone for this block. You can just replace the torches with glowstone and make it look better, but since it's a starter farm, I'm using torches with a block there. Alright, now we're going to find the side you want your collection system on, so I'm going to put it right here. So make sure it's aligned with this composter here, and then just go ahead and break a block there, and that will be like a little marker. Put blocks around the entire perimeter of this. I'm just going to use some stone bricks here just to make it look better, just little 2 pillars, and then just put wood around, but it's really your preference. I'm just doing my style. Okay, now that you have all of this surrounded, just go ahead and place down slabs on top. These can be any types of slabs you want. I'm just using stone brick slabs. And just do that all along the tops of the perimeter. Alright, now we're going to create a collection system. So on this little marker here, just break down another block like so, and then place down a chest. This is where all of your food is going to be collected when the villager throws it. So place down a hopper on going into the chest like so, and then place down a rail facing this way, so it's like that. And then place down a minecart with a hopper, and then break the rail beneath. Like so. Now place down a trapdoor. This can be any type of trapdoor. Place it on this block here on the top block like so. You can also place a slab on top of the trapdoor, but it's not necessary. Now we're going to make the little walkway down to where you're going to access all of your food. So just break down some blocks like this. So one block here, go down 2, and then go down 3. Just like this. And then just break that again. And on the other side over here, break 1, 2, and then 3, and then just go all the way down. So it's going to be like a little stairway. This is obviously not necessary to put down the stairs, but it's just for aesthetics and functionality. So just like this, and that is going to be the little walkway down to access your food. Now once you have this part completed, go ahead and place a block here where the hopper is. So you should have a little block there, and then make sure to just block this in like this. And this is the part where you're gonna have to get your villager inside. So I'm just gonna block this off, like make a little area where your villager is gonna be. And what you're gonna have to do is just nudge them in there, just like so, and just make a little area for the boat to get into. So just get your villager and make sure he is professionless, so meaning he doesn't have a job, and just roam all the way over to the area to put him in. Alright, so you're gonna row your villager inside of this little chamber here, and then you're just gonna get out of your boat and just block this off like this, and then break the boat. So your villager, oh, he went right in. So just block that off, and that was really lucky. So he is gonna be trapped there forever. And then also, for this part here, I kind of forgot to put the villager in. Just do the same thing. This part is a lot easier. Just get your villager and roam inside of the little area where he's gonna start farming. So just put the boat inside and then do the same thing I did. Just block this area off and then just break the boat, and he should become a farmer anytime soon with the composter here. And sometimes these villagers don't receive their workstation. It's really weird. And as you can see, I just got my villager to become a farmer. It takes a little bit, it's kind of iffy, but they will eventually become a farmer. So you just have to constantly replace the composter and then just wait a little bit, and they will eventually become a farmer villager. And now what you're gonna do is pick the crop of your choice. And I mentioned in the beginning of the video that wheat doesn't work too well. I don't know what it is, but it just doesn't work for the villagers. And then all you have to do now is just pre-plant your crop. It can be carrot, potato, or beetroot, and the villagers will farm that. So just pre-plant all of your crops in the little area here. And if you want to help the villager out even more, you can just place down some carrots on the ground, and he will eventually pick them up and put them into his inventory. As you can see, he just picked it up, and his inventory is now full, because I gave him quite a bit of carrots before. Alright, so you just finished the first part of the automated villager food farm. Now all you have to do for the second part is just follow these steps. I'm just gonna start you out with this collection area. So just do the same thing. Just place down a chest here, like so, and put a hopper into the top. It might be a little difficult because the villager is in there, but just place down a hopper there, and then a rail with your minecart, and then break the rail below. And then just follow the first part of the video to do it on the other side. And that is literally it. And after you build this farm, you literally don't have to do anything else. You don't have to do any maintenance. And just let your potatoes and carrots roll in. And if you guys enjoyed this tutorial, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're new around here, consider subscribing. It means a lot to me. And see you in the next video. Bye bye. Thank you.